All right, hello there, ladies and gentlemen. This is Crazy Kitsune Gaming, and this is episode 5 of the Sonic Generations walkthrough, aka How to Beat Sonic Generations 105, aka, I'm running out of names to call this at this point. Now, I was actually about to pull a knobhead move and say, "Oh, it's time to fight the boss now," but then I remembered, you actually need to get keys from some of the areas. Yeah, remember when I said that there are areas above the levels themselves that have like little side levels you can do? Well, yeah, it's time to talk about that. See, to actually fight the final boss of whatever area you're in, you actually need to get those keys from each of the areas. And I realized the robot can probably explain it a bit better than I can. Yeah, about boss gates. Leads you to where the boss is, however, it is locked. You need to get 3 boss gate keys. Clear one challenge act in either Act 1 or 2 to obtain a key, and you need to do that for each of the levels. So, yeah, we're gonna do that. I'm actually going to do kind of like how I did the levels themselves. I'm gonna be doing one as modern Sonic and one as classic Sonic. That way, you guys have options. So yeah, let's just pick a level, any level, and beat it. Oh yeah, not this one. Yeah, no, I don't feel like falling down more. I like ground that's actually stable. So yeah, as you can see, they actually have a certain challenge number where it's saying how difficult it should be. Now, this is Jump Rush. I think this one is actually the easiest one of the side levels that you need to beat in Green Hill. So yeah, we're just gonna go for it. Where basically you just need to master, I say with quotation pause, the jump panels. Yeah, it's honestly not that hard of a level. You just kinda gotta know how to use jump panels, which is as easy as running across them. Oh yeah, that is a dangerous thing about the level. We got quite a few enemies to worry about. So yeah, keep that in mind. Oh yeah, and we haven't ran into these things before. Yeah, these are sort of, I'm about to sound like I'm talking about a computer here or something. These are firewalls. Yeah, you can't actually get through those without dying. But it's fine because they just have a jump panel here. Oh yeah, and we have a close look at the mines, which obviously, if you bump into them, you can you guess? You get hurt. Yeah, it's really weird how that works. Yeah, let's just jump up here. Oh yeah. And oh god, I actually died. Okay. And I said that this level was really easy. I was trying to jump over to the other route, and I kind of realized it probably wouldn't have been worth it anyway. That was a weird air boost. Let's try that again. What in the world? Okay. Okay. I thought I knew something about this game. Maybe I don't. Maybe I'm just a moron, who knows? Alright, and okay. We're just gonna grind on the rails like normal people. Like normal hedgehogs. There we go. Oof. Alright, up and over the loop-de-loop. I say up and over, more like going through. We're going through the loop-de-loop. That's what I should be saying. There we go. Ah, yes, a little swingy thingy. Everybody loves a swingy thingy. Nobody loves spikes, though. There we go, another dash ring. Slide. Ooh, yeah, that's a long thing of spikes. By the way, if you boost on those jump panels, they actually will usually take you a bit farther. So yeah, I did kind of say there's not much to master about them. There's like a little bit to master about them. That's one down. And no, I do not want to play through it again. Oh yeah, also, the first time you clear each of these levels, you will have these little bells, and they'll be gold when you first complete the levels. And when you hit them, they'll spawn a little music note. And they'll kind of fly around and try to avoid you, but if you get those music notes, then you'll actually get collectibles, like, you know, music or artwork that you can see in the, you know, your little house near the hub area. So yeah, that's something to keep in mind. It's a fun little thing you can do. Now let's find another one. I do not want to do Swing Set Circus. I don't think someone just trying to get through the game could survive that one. Yeah, let's do Buzz Bomber's Revenge, because it's hard. There are easier ones, but it's not, like, so ridiculous that if you try to do this one, then you're just going to fail. Oh yeah, also, I forgot to even mention this in the first one. Yeah, there's a timer in the middle of the top part of the screen. You actually are limited in how much time you have to complete these. So, yeah, some haste is required to do these. Oh yeah, but you can find those little clocks that will give you more time. Before you ask, no, I did not have, like, some malicious plan on how to show that to you. Because, like, you know what malicious plan implies? Plan, and I don't have a plan. Alright. Up through here. There we go. And a good spin dash. And maybe a good fall as well. Oh yeah, we're actually gonna have to go down, aren't we? Ah yes, and once again, more of the blue Buzz Bombers that don't do anything but fly around. Oh, I don't think I can quite get that guy. Yeah, no, I think he's just out of reach. That's a shame. But that's not gonna stop us from getting through the level. Because again, the blue Buzz Bombers don't actually attack you. Alright. Boing. What a lovely sound. Yep, that was a swing and a miss there, buddy. Oh, we even got to a higher route. Oh yeah, and you can find gold clocks too, which give you 10 extra seconds. Ooh, okay, we're gonna need to get some momentum with the spin dash. Bonk. Alright. Yeah, things are going nice and steady so far. Don't shoot me with that, thank you. Boing. Ooh, that's a lot of them, okay. Okay. Alright. And that looks like a goalpost. Alright, so yeah, you'll just have to do levels like that. I think only one of them in each of the areas. And then you should get the boss gate keys. Or they should, you know, appear in the area. So yeah, I think that's about it for this episode. I don't really have much else to say other than maybe consider liking and subscribing, because we are a relatively new channel and it would be so helpful and so appreciated if you could like and subscribe, and maybe even show it to your friends so that they can do the exact same thing. And I think that's about it. Just, you know, have a good day, and I'll see you in the chemical plant levels, because we've got to do some of those as well.